제165회. 자, 어디 가서 차나 한잔 할까요?
안녕하세요. Hello everyone and welcome to Let's Speak Korean. 반갑습니다. 저는 Lisa Kelly입니다. I'm your host Lisa Kelly and next to me is my co-host. Why don't you say hello?
안녕하세요. I'm Stephen Revere. Thank you for being with us for another episode of Let's Speak Korean. And today we've got a little way to invite somebody to do something. And here's the people we're going to be inviting.
Yeah. Hi everybody. 여러분 안녕하세요. My name is Marina. Nice to meet you today.
안녕하세요 여러분. 연희티입니다. Nice to meet you all today.
All right, well, I guess we can just jump right into our program today. Here is our flash animation with our lessons for today.
Wrap it up
with Lisa
and Steven.
자, 어디 가서 차나 한잔 할까요?
미안하지만 전 좀 피곤해서 먼저 가야겠어요.
아쉽네요. 그럼 내일 봐요.
다음에 마시기로 해요.
All right, in the first line, Stephen asks Lisa, hey, let's go to, I think it's Samcha that we're up to now, right? So they're going to go drink some tea is what he's offering her. He says, 자, 어디 가서 차나 한잔 할까요? 자, 자 is like this expression that Koreans like to use. It means like, okay, now, and it's kind of like, you know, getting everyone's attention. 자, Stephen, explain the sentence.
You know where I always see this is on the TV shows where they've got the little kids around, and there's, 자, 친구들, 이거 합시다. Whenever they're inviting a big group of people to go do right. something like mm-hmm. that, and on TV shows, you'll see it a lot of the time, too, 자, 이제는, and then when they're going to move on to doing something right. next, they kind of introduce it with this, 자, and then it goes on to, 어디 가서, should we go somewhere? 어디 here is not just where, it's somewhere. Mm-hmm. 어디 가서, 차는 한잔 할까요? 차는 한잔 할까요? Have a cup of tea or something. That na
is. The na is like or something or, you know, it's kind of like leaves the sentence open to something else. So they're giving you one selection, but they're open to other ideas is what the na is there
for. Sure, you guys have had this before, choosing between two nouns, right? 커피 나 차 마실까요? Should we have coffee or tea is what you're asking. In this instance, if you don't add another noun after it, it means that or anything else mm-hmm. along those lines.
All right, and that's how we use the na. And then the second sentence we have is Lisa says, 미안하지만, 미안하다, everyone knows is sorry, but 미안하지만, 전 좀 피곤해서 먼저 가야겠어요. I'm a little tired, so I think I should go now. Stephen, I heard that...
미안하지만, sorry, but... And then it goes on to... 좀 피곤해서, I'm a little tired, so 먼저 가야겠어요. You need to learn this expression. Again, 통째로 외우세요. 먼저 가야겠어요. I have to leave first, okay? Very common expression used all the time in Korea. The thing that really confuses us here is this get. I'm gonna have to leave. You can understand that. But you could also say 가야 해요, 가야 돼요, right? We've learned that before. You might be saying, why aren't they saying that? Throwing in a get makes things more polite for some bizarre reason. There's a lot of strange. The one I never can really understand is 몰라요 turns into 모르겠어요. Wait, I will not know. In English, it sounds crazy. What are you talking? I will not know 모르겠어요. But they do it all the time. And the other one that is used all the time is to know, to not know, and to know 알겠어요.
Right. How about some examples? Okay, Marina, you know, girls are always concerned about dieting. So how about this? This year, I should do some exercise. I should work out some. How can you use that using 야겠어요?
제가 운동을 해야겠어요.
Okay, 운동을.
운동을 okay. 해야겠어요.
Good. 올해는 운동을 좀 해야겠어요. Okay, Nitti, how about this year, I should really make a girlfriend. Find a girlfriend.
좋은 여자가 있으면 좀 봐야겠어요.
봐야 되겠어요? 봐야겠어요. 만나야겠어요. Okay, all of these work. Okay, very good. And the next line we have is Stephen says, 아쉽네요. I'll stop this right here because this is actually a good word to memorize. 아쉽네요. This is showing regret or you're sorry that you couldn't do something. In this case, Stephen wanted to go and have some you know, go to Samcha, have some cha or drink something. And she said no, so she's like, oh, he's like, darn, well, maybe next time. 아쉽네요.
Yeah, again, 통째로 외우세요. You got to memorize this whole expression. We've got a lot of good expressions here today. 아쉽네요. Ah, it's really sad that you have to get going right now is what they're mm-hmm. saying, right? Oh, it's really too bad. 아쉽네요. And that's followed by 그럼 내일 봐요. And 그럼 is in that case, then 내일, tomorrow, 봐요, see you tomorrow.
Okay, and the last one, Lisa says, 다음에 마시기로 해요, 기도해요. This is a good one, too. Okay, let's promise to do something, or let's do something, right?
Again, we're drinking again, right? Yeah. 마시기로 해요, to drink, right? 만나기로 해요. Sure, you could just be tea. Mm-hmm. 마시기로 해요, sure, because I invited you for tea at the beginning, you're right, yes. And you can also invite somebody to meet you this
sure.
way, right? 다음에 만나기로 해요, right? Mm-hmm. Next week, let's get together. 다음 주에 만나기로 해요.
Right. And for those of you who've just been watching our show and not really getting into studying, 아쉽네요. How about next time? 꼭 시작하기로 해요. Start next time. Or start today. 오늘부터 시작하기로 해요. Why don't you start studying Korean
make
from
today? Make a decision
today?
To do it. Yeah.
Right.
Make sure you're going to do it. Mm-hmm. 공부하기로 하세요. Yeah.
Okay. Well, let's review some of these lines one by one, okay? 어디 가서 차나 한잔 할까요?
어디 가서 차나 한잔 할까요?
전 좀 피곤해서 먼저 가야겠어요.
좀 피곤해서 먼저 가야겠어요.
전 좀 피곤해서 좀 가야겠어요.
Very good. And the last one, 다음에 마시기로 해요. We practiced that. And I think it's time for Korean Insight. Let's go on to our wonderful cultural corner here, Korean Insight. Korean Insight.
And for today's Korean Insight, ladies and gentlemen, we have come to a 부동산, and that is a real estate agent. And these are the people who can help you find a rental apartment or an apartment to buy in Korea if you'd like to. Oh, just a little while ago, a foreigner couldn't buy land in Korea, but now you can. And it's a great way to study Korean. You could go rent an apartment. Maybe you won't rent an apartment, but it can't hurt to come into a 부동산 and practice your Korean. Learn how to use a few new phrases and maybe learn a few new words, too. It's a great way to practice. And you might learn a word like one room. What's a one room? That is a studio apartment. And now back to the studio.
All right, with that said, why don't we ask Steve again to give us some grammar tips for today.
Okay, pay attention for the na that's in there, right? 차 나 한 잔 할까요? You want to go get a glass of tea or something. And then in the beginning there, that 어디, remember, is some place, not where. 어디 갈까요? 가서 차 나 한 잔 할까요? And then in the next line, they say 가야겠어요, right? Oh, I've got to get going, okay? 가야겠어요, 먼저 가야겠어요.
And then 뭘 기도해요, we had that, is when we're promising someone, let's promise to do something. That was the last one. So with that said, 한 번 더 볼까요? Okay, I think it's time for us to look at the flash animation one more time. 공부 한 번 더 하기로 해요, 복습하기로 해요.
자, 어디 가서 차나 한잔 할까요?
미안하지만 전 좀 피곤해서 먼저 가야겠어요.
아쉽네요. 그럼 내일 봐요.
다음에 마시기로 해요.
Okay, before we end the show, I noticed that earlier Mariana had a little bit of trouble with the pronunciation because we're saying 전 좀 피곤해요.
When it's you difficult, say, those J's right in there, the G.
I think it's also because you have the all E on one and then O on the next one,
yeah.
That's why. So let's practice that one last time. 전 좀 피곤해서. 전 좀 피곤해서.
전 피곤해서.
Very good.
전 좀 피곤해서.
Nice. And like I said, we can say goodbye to everyone with this one. 아, 시간이 없네요. 아쉽네요. 그럼 내일 봐요. Or actually next week for us. 다음 주에 봐요.
시간이 없네요. 아쉽네요. 내일 봐요.
다음 주에 봐요.
다음 주 봐요.
네, 다음 주에 봐요. 만나기로 해요.
Bye.
Bye.
IronTV.com.